Secretary DOPT, Dr. C. Chandramouli, officers of the 2016 batch of the IAS. I welcome the 176 officers of the 2016 batch of the Indian Administrative Service to Rashtrapati Bhavan. I congratulate you on having completed your training, capped by a 13-week posting at the rank of Assistant Secretary in 58 different ministries and departments of the Government of India. You are now ready to depart for your respective states and take up your new duties in hundreds of districts that comprise the reality of our country. This is a good moment to look back at your training as well as plan for your future and for the future of India. The IAS is our premier All India service. It is one of those institutions that knit together our country with a common governance framework, a shared administrative ethos, and by promoting a uniform culture and value system in public service. As IAS officers in the districts and state capitals, you will also be responsible for implementation of national and union government programs. These may sometimes be tailored or adapted for local conditions. This makes you an important link between the Government of India and the state government. It is incumbent upon you to bring the learning, expertise, experience, and of course, standards of integrity of an elite All India service to every rung of government in the very diverse country. Given this, it is important that you understand how the union government and the ministries and departments work even before you leave for your states. This is the exposure that the short period of service as assistant secretaries is designed to give you. Since the government began in 2013, you are the fourth batch of the IAS to benefit from this innovation. पिछले कुछ सप्ताह के दौरान आपने उन मंत्रालयों के कामकाज और अन्य बारीकियों की जानकारी भी प्राप्त की होगी जिनमें काम के लिए आपको भेजा गया था। आपने एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स आकांक्षी जिलों और ग्राम स्वराज अभियान जैसे मौलिक राष्ट्रीय कार्यक्रमों और आयुष्मान भारत जैसी प्रमुख सामाजिक इनिशिएटिव्स के बारे में भी जानकारी हासिल की होगी। आपने ये भी महसूस किया होगा कि चाहे आप इन कार्यक्रमों से सीधे ना भी जुड़े हों तो भी आपके काम काज पर इनका प्रभाव अवश्य पड़ेगा। Addressing issues of districts that have been left behind in our developmental journey, whether due to infrastructure, social indices, or logistical challenges, involves more than one department or ministry. Similarly, a national health coverage scheme is vital to safeguard our human capital as a social as well as an economic resource. It is not just a concern for the Department of Ministry of Health only. These programs, along with others such as Make in India, Digital India, and Smart Cities and Urbanization Program, Swachh Bharat, the quest for renewable energy, greater integration of technology into agriculture and farm productivity, are ambitious and daring. They constitute a giant leap for our society. These are also programs that will run in parallel with your professional lives. They will be your legacy. Many of you will end your careers as secretaries in the 2040s, perhaps at about the time India celebrates the 100th anniversary of independence. Today we are a $2.5 trillion economy. By the 2040s, our GDP will be 6 or 7 times as large. Few generations in India's history would have seen such a dramatic transformation. You are destiny's chosen generation. As IAS officers of your generation, it will be your mandate to equip our people, equip our government, and equip our country to deal with the challenges and opportunities of an economy of that size. This will call for enhancing use of technology in the way you work and function. It will call for breaking out of silos and seeing government as a seamless service provider, not as a series of closed compartments. Above all, it will call for a radical overhaul of the nature of administration and of the interface between citizen and government. You must have observed, while every officer who used to finish his or her address, I used to clap and give applaud to whatever you have learned and whatever you have projected here. At that time, I remember only 2 days back, I happened to be in Chhattisgarh, a very remote and Naxalites dominated region that is known as Bastar. And the district was Dantewada. There, I take it as my privilege to visit one of the self-help groups. And there was one smart class. I was asked to attend that class as a student. Of course, I took it as my privilege. I want to share with you a few observations. There, a student of maybe higher secondary school, she became my teacher. Of course, in a smart class. First of all, I inquired from her, "Bete, are you a student or a teacher?" Uska seedha jawab tha, "Rashtrapati ji, main student hoon, lekin aapke liye aaj main teacher banke aayi hoon." Mujhe bahut acha laga. Achha isliye laga, that small girl, she was full of self-confidence, a tribal girl, we can't imagine rather. And the moment I used to applaud for you, it was just to give you a sense of comfort level and to give you a sense of confidence. You do have, I don't dispute, but the real test which you will face in life when you will find many people who approach you, they are not pro-development, they are used to corrupt practices, and those people will not be outsiders, but from amongst your subordinates. Please do remember, the real test of your integrity will be at that time. If you face the truth, if you stand for justice, whether it is economic or social, I think you will succeed. In the last, you have no, this is quite a task. You have no option but to succeed. as you go to your respective districts and become change agents in your state cadres, our country's future is in your hands. I am confident you will be equal to this responsibility, and I wish you all the best. Thank you. I will be happy to have a group photo with you all officers.